We're going to spin the roulette wheel and see what questions you and I are going to talk about.
And bad news is good news in the world of journalism.
I like the idea of using AI to help us communicate and teach and explain better. And, oh, I can't wait to see what it's going to be. Let's see.
I am just, this is funny.
Okay. All right. So here's question number one. Is AI a bubble that's about to burst? So you and I can talk about this.
Let's go through this.
And this is timely because we're still hearing a lot in the news about an AI bubble.
Yeah, no, this is all over the news. And I do not think it's going to burst. I think we are through a transitionary period, which is very timely. But I definitely don't think it's about to burst. Contrary to what every journalist on the planet seems to think, because, you know, if it bleeds, it leads, and bad news is good news in the world of journalism. But I really don't think it's about to burst, all kidding aside. I do think we're going through a transitionary period. I think we've invested massive amounts of money in its build out for data centers, obviously. We've spent a lot of money in training a lot of these foundation models. At some point, we're really going to run out of information to train those models with. And a lot of that money has been spent on the, we'll call it the pre-training part of the model creation process. We're going to move into a completely different phase. And that phase, I think, will be inference largely and actual use of those models in a way that is much different than they're being used today. We're going to move from, I call it the, I don't know, personal productivity tool to deeply embedded in organizations. And that compute is all going to be used and all that investment's going to be used. And I think that's when you're going to start seeing a real massive return on this investment.
So that's interesting, because one of the things that I read the other day, someone was saying that their conjecture was that there literally were more data centers being built, that there aren't enough people. If every man, woman, and child in the United States had a $20 a month subscription to an AI model, that still wouldn't be enough people to pay for all these data centers being built. Like, what's your take on that? Is it come down to this embedded AI concept that will make that suddenly be a good investment?
I think, well, look, we know AI is ultimately going to be permeating part of every single application, every part of our lives, I think, at some point. And I might, you know, it's not hyperbole. I really, truly think it's going to be a part of every single application that we use on a regular basis. So, no, I don't think that data center space is going to be a waste of money. I think it will be used. It's funny because it kind of reminds me back to those days when they had built that oldest fiber across the entire planet. They spent an enormous amount of money on fiber optic cable. And, you know, for years we've heard about, well, the fiber's dark, it's not being used. The fiber's dark, it's not being used. And, you know, seemingly overnight, they couldn't start building it fast enough again because all that quote-unquote dark fiber was now being used and they needed a lot more fiber. You know, and again, it's hard to predict what the future is going to be, clearly. But, if I'm about to look out in the future, so little of AI is being used right now, and so few individuals or so few companies are genuinely really using it, that once they start really using it, I think you're going to see the opposite occur. They're going to need more electric, more capacity, more data centers. I can't see how it goes any other way.
Now, the interesting part for me, though, is that the definition of a bubble is sometimes simply expectations versus reality, right?
Right.
So I do worry that there is this overinflated set of expectations among sort of the general populace,
right?
That AI is going to magically change the world and it's not going to take any effort. It's just going to put an easy button on everything they do, right? And we see that with people who, you know, use AI to generate their work and they don't put in the effort to actually use it appropriately.
Right.
What happens when those people become disillusioned? Like, is that a little bit of a bubble? Maybe not a strictly economic bubble, but an expectations bubble that we could see?
I think you're starting to see the beginnings of an expectations bubble now burst a little bit. I think genuinely, especially most organizations, they had this perspective or this perception that things was magic and, you know, we'll give people ChatGPT and Claude and all of a sudden great things are going to occur. And we realize, and you and I have been saying this literally for the better part of 2 years, that is not the case. That maybe will burst a little bit, but I think population and corporations in general are getting better educated in the capabilities, starting to understand the limitations of the current model, thinking about things a little bit differently. Now, this is going to be a journey. It's not going to happen overnight. And I think once that starts to occur, those that maybe had a bit of trepidation or those that where their perception bubble bursts and they really start to truly understand the capabilities, you're going to see an uptick, a dramatic uptick. I can't see it going any other way.
Yeah, I see at a human level, you've got humans who are slowly coming to terms with the fact that this is not a magic easy button. It's right. actually a tool that requires effort and skill to use yes. effectively. I think that corporations, many of them, most of them maybe, are lagging behind. Like, they're still rolling this out as a tool to people.
Right.
But they're not yet broadly grasping the idea of embedding it into business processes.
No, and not even close. Work, right? You and I have spoken about this 100 times. We could probably do a whole podcast on it. I think first, you know, a lot of the companies sold them these tools that magic was going to occur. And you and I looked at it and go, roll our eyes and go, there's no way. And then the other issue out there is, and you know, you can argue with us all you want, feel free. Most companies, the CEO is putting AI under the CIO, the chief information mm-hmm. officer. And I think that is a real fundamental mistake. It doesn't belong right. there. And I think that's a big issue as well. And as an engineer and technologist for decades, I can say this, this is not the type of tool you put under technologists. It just doesn't belong there. There's a whole aspect of rolling this out, understanding deep business processes that is far more critical. And I would argue that this needs to be broken out of IT and probably a cross-functional type of role in the first mm-hmm. place that honestly reports up to the CEO.
But and it sounds like also you're saying, though, as business really figures out how to use this tool more effectively, we will see a whole new set of demand unlocked 100%. That doesn't exist yet.
Absolutely. You know, I think that's just a matter of time. You know,
okay.
project that time? I don't know. I can't guess that, but I don't think it's that far off in the future.
All right. So you heard it here. Peter says there is no AI bubble.
So invest.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoy this podcast, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe to us over on YouTube. And make sure to stay up to date with us on Apple Podcasts and Spotify as well.